Hey guys, a very warm welcome to Arihant Online Academy, and here it is question number 61 for the preparation of your Hindustan Aeronautics Limited management trainee post. And question number 61 is, how do you initialize an array in C? So it is very basic concept of C, basic concept of C language, and I hope you all know that, initially we need to write the type of our variable, that is integer type variable is there, then we are declaring an array, then we need rectangular braces for declaring the size of array, then we need curly braces under which we are defining the elements which existed in this spaces, and then semicolon. So option C is the correct answer. This is the correct way to initialize an array in C. And guys, I have uploaded previous 6 videos also, in which 10 questions in each video we have discussed. So you can watch these videos by going to the description section. In description section, all these links are mentioned, guys. And guys, do subscribe our YouTube channel and like the video so that we can get at least a response from you that whether you want to continue this kind of videos in future also or not. So that basically this video will gonna helpful for your all upcoming CSIT exam, right? And this will gonna very, very helpful for you. So if you really want to get continue this video, guys, please do respond in comment section as well and do like. So the question number 62 here is, what is the number of edges present in complete graph having n vertices? So again, it is very, very simple question, guys. You can take an example of a rectangle, means 4 vertices is here. Right, 4 vertices are here, n equals to 4, and we need a complete graph. In a complete graph, they have asked, na? So this is our complete graph. Complete graph means each and every edge should be meet with each and other every edge, right? So this is our complete graph with vertices 4. V stands for vertices. Now, how many total edges are there? So you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So general formula to calculate this is n into n minus 1 divided by 2. If you will put 4 on the place of n, you will get 4 into 3 divided by 2. That is 4, 3 is 12 divided by 2 equals to 6. And we, here we have 6 edges, isn't it, guys? So option B is the correct answer. Very simple formula. You can also keep it memorized so that you can answer it very fastly, right? Whenever you want to attempt in your exam, because this is general formula. I think in class 10th or 9th mathematics also it existed, right? Next question is, assuming int of 4 bytes, what is the size of int array 15? So basically, for one integer, we have size of 4 bytes. So for 15 integer, 15 multiply with 4, that is 60 bytes. 60 bytes is the correct answer. So option D is the correct answer. Easy question. Next one is, elements in an array are accessed randomly, sequentially, exponentially, or logarithmically. So we can access elements in an array randomly, right? If I have 10 size of array, right? Then I can directly access A2. I can also access A9, right? Whatever I want. So it is random access is possible in array, and sequential access is possible in linked list. In linked list, sequential access is possible, right? So here option A is the correct one. Next question is, how many children does a binary tree have? So binary tree may have 0 children, may have 1 children, or may have 2 children, but at most 2 children should it have, right? It can't have more than 2. So 0, 1, or 2. Option C is the correct answer, guys. Next one is, heap can be used as priority queue, stacks, a decreasing order array, or normal array. So heap, basically the property of heap is the root element. It is our root element. It is our root node. So root node is either greatest than this two nodes, or it is lesser than these two nodes. Either it should be greater than these two nodes, or either it should be lesser than both these nodes, both these two nodes. So this satisfies the property of priority queue. So it can be used as a priority queue. Option A is the correct answer. Next one is, what is a hash function, guys? So a function has allotted memory to keys, or a function that computes the location of the key in the array, or a function that creates an array, or a function that computes the location of the values in the array. So hashing, in hashing topic of data structure, we have discussed many times that hash function is that computes the location of the key in the array, right? Suppose H5 is there, so it will compute the location of fifth key. So option B is the correct answer, guys. Next question is, in simple chaining, what data structure is appropriate? So in simple chaining, we use doubly linked list. Why we use? Because we have discussed in our chaining lectures also in hashing that doubly linked list basically helps easier. It helps easier while deleting the elements. That is why we use doubly linked list. So option B is the correct answer. And next one is, which of the following statement for a simple graph is correct? Option A, every path is a trail. Option B, every trail is a path. Option C, every trail is a path as well as every path is a trail. Or option D, path and trail have no relation. So basically, what is path? Path is every vertices should be distinct here, should be distinct. And what is trail? In trail, every edge should be distinct. So in path, every vertice should be different, but in trail, every edge should be distinct. So every path is a trail, because if vertice itself is a distinct, there is no question arises of existing different or same trail, existing same trail, right? So every path is a trail. Option A is the correct answer. Next question is, which of the following concepts make extensive use of arrays? Option A, binary trees. Option B, scheduling of processes. Option C, caching. Or option D, spatial locality. So basically, for arrays, spatial locality is the concept which make its use extensive in it. Why? Because spatial locality means quickly access, right? So we can quickly access arrays by just pointing the location number of that, or it can also refer to its nearby locations. Spatial locality means it can also refer to its nearby locations. So option D is the correct answer, that because of spatial locality, one of the important reason to use array is spatial locality in programming. Okay, guys. So we have discussed this 10 questions in this video. So guys, if you are finding any kind of doubts or queries in any video, in any question, do comment us. I will try to solve your all queries and doubts as early as possible. Do subscribe, hit comment, hit the bell button, do like, and guys, do subscribe and share with your friends. Have a very, very nice day, guys. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.